This video will certify you to use AQUALAB 4 series water activity meters. Today we'll be using this AQUALAB 4TE and 4TEV, but the instructions also apply to the AQUALAB 4 and Duo. Select a clean, level place that has a relatively stable temperature. Small temperature changes won't affect your AQUALAB's performance, but it shouldn't be located near heating or air conditioning vents. Plug the AQUALAB in and turn it on. You'll hear fans starting up. The fans keep the block temperature as stable as possible. Please let your instrument warm up for 15 minutes. There are four different types of AQUALAB water activity meters. The one we're using in this video is the AQUALAB 4TE. It uses the chilled mirror dew point method to measure water activity. To understand how it works, let's look at the inside of the sample chamber. When a sample is put into the chamber and the block is sealed, it comes to vapor equilibrium. Water molecules enter the air above the sample, and then the mirror is chilled until dew forms. The chilled mirror method is a primary measurement method, and it's the fastest, most accurate way to measure water activity. This is our most popular water activity meter, and it's the choice of about two-thirds of our customers that buy water activity meters. There are a few ingredients like propylene glycol and alcohols that can cause issues with the mirror. The problem with these volatile ingredients is that they also condense on the mirror. When we heat the mirror up, they evaporate at a different rate than water, and they interfere with the readings. The Series 4 TDL uses a tunable diode laser to overcome this problem. The beam of the laser is less than 1 nanometer wide and is specific to the characteristics of water. It detects only water vapor molecules and is unaffected by volatile molecules in the headspace. The sensor can measure the water activity of samples that were previously impossible to read, including ethanol, gasoline, and pure alcohol. The Series 4 TEV features a capacitance sensor alongside the chilled mirror sensor. The capacitance sensor is a secondary measurement method. It's good enough for many situations, but not on the same level as the dew point and tunable diode laser sensors. The Series 4 TEV lets you choose the sensor you want, using the higher accuracy dew point sensor for most of the time, and the capacitance sensor for samples that have volatiles in them. One thing common to all these instruments is the screen. There are three screens that you can cycle through by pressing this button. The first one is the measurement screen, the second is the configuration screen, and the third is the stored data screen, where you can cycle through the last 8,000 measurements you have made. In practice, we found that most users need a more robust way of handling and managing their data. So we created Scala, a digital quality record system built to gather data through the natural work processes of the quality lab. Any lab instrument with a communication port can connect to Scala, and that includes all Series 4 instruments. We have our Series 4 TE connected to Scala today. If you were not using Scala in your lab, you would simply need to be recording your test results manually. Before we actually take some sample measurements, we'd like to talk about sample preparation. When we tested how sample prep affects water activity readings, we found 5 things that will improve the accuracy of your readings. 1.
Use clean sampling practices. Place your instrument in a clean location. Make sure you have clean hands or wear lab gloves. Use a clean sample cup for each reading. Fill your sample cup no more than half full. Wipe the bottom, the edges, and the rim of your sample cup with a Kim wipe before putting it in the instrument so you don't contaminate the sample chamber. Even small amounts of water or contamination can significantly affect the reading.
2. Protect your sample. The water activity of your sample changes as it's exposed to ambient conditions, so keep it covered. Put a lid on the sample if it will sit out for longer than a minute. If it will be waiting longer than a half an hour, seal the lid with parafilm. 3.
Your sample temperature and block temperature need to be in the same general range before your reading can be taken. If it's too hot, water can condense on the inside of the sensor chamber. This ruins your water activity readings. If your sample is too hot or too cold, the instrument will ask you to take the sample out. If the temperature is only off by a few degrees, the instrument will wait as the sample comes to temperature. One way to reduce read times is by bringing the sample to temperature before putting it in the instrument. If the temperature differences are slowing down your read process, consider purchasing a temperature equilibration tray, which brings samples to a set temperature before you read them.
4. Take a representative sample. Whatever you put in the cup should be as close as possible to what the consumer takes out of the package. If the product won't fit, break it to fit, while minimizing handling. If it's a multi-component product like filled cake, cheese and crackers, or cereal with fruit, get a representative sample. By representative, we mean that all the components of the product should be represented in the same ratio as they are in the actual product. There are a couple of products that need special handling. Products with a moisture barrier, like coated candies, may be slow to come to equilibrium. They can be cut or crushed to expose the interior. Don't grind them, though. This causes moisture loss. In high-fat products, like fatty meat and desserts, the oil and fats become a moisture barrier. These products are slow to emit moisture. The sensors will work equally fast on these products, but the products themselves simply need a longer time to come to equilibration. A quick testing method will give you an inaccurate result. If you're testing these kinds of products, you may want to talk to someone on our support team about how to get the fastest, most accurate test results. 5. Minimize handling. In sample preparation, less is more. We've seen customers use all kinds of sample prep methods over the years, including grinders, food processors, and blenders. There are two problems here. First, the friction of the grinding process heats the sample, driving off moisture and changing its water activity. Second, the increased surface area means that the product loses or gains moisture more quickly, making it more susceptible to the effects of room humidity. Establish a standard operating procedure to specify how samples are prepared and be consistent. Your procedure should include how the sample is handled while waiting to be read, and the temperature the sample and instrument should be at during the reading. When you set up this protocol, consider running your own tests to find which preparation method produces the most stable result. The safety and quality of your product depends on its water activity reading, and the quality of your water activity reading depends on the performance of your water activity instrument. Fortunately, you can use salt solutions with a known water activity to verify that your instrument is performing correctly. Often these verifications need to be documented, and auditors and inspectors will expect to see these values. There are 5 verification standards available for your instrument: 0.250, 0.500, 0.760, 0.920, and 0.984. These salt solutions are tested with a densiometer, which allows us to know their concentration very accurately. The best way to verify your instrument is to use a technique we call bracketing. If you're measuring a cookie that typically has a water activity of 0.60, you should use the 0.500 and 0.760 standards to verify. If you're measuring milk powder in the 0.3 range, you should use the 0.250 and 0.500 standards to verify. We are running our verification in Scala, so the verification record can be attached to all the measurements we take this shift. But you can also record the details of your verification manually. Any reading within 0.003 of your solution's water activity is fine, as long as you're using the chilled mirror sensor. If you're checking the volatile sensor, any reading with 0.01 of your standard is fine. To clean the instrument, use your AQUALAB cleaning kit. One is included with your instrument. You will get a new kit after each annual calibration. Order a replacement kit at sales.food@metergroup.com or by calling 509-332-5601. There are 3 steps to cleaning the sample chamber surface area and sensors. 1. Wash with isopropyl alcohol or cleaning solution. 2. Rinse with distilled water. 3. Dry with a clean wipe. To start, turn off the power to your instrument and unplug the power cord. Wash your hands thoroughly or wear lab gloves so dirt and natural oils on your hands don't contaminate the cleaning materials or the sensors. Open the lid to the sample chamber. You should see the mirror, the thermopile, the optical sensor, and the fan. The AQUALAB 4TEV, vapor sorption analyzer, pocket, and light also have capacitance filters. You should not clean or allow any moisture to come into contact with the white filter covering the capacitance sensor. If the filter has been contaminated, it needs to be replaced. Replacement filters are included in your cleaning kit. Start the cleaning process by moistening a large chem wipe with isopropyl alcohol or AQUALAB cleaning solution, and then wiping down the surface areas of the sample chamber. Because of regulations, we do not ship isopropyl alcohol in the cleaning kits, but it is often the best cleaning agent, particularly if you are measuring samples with a high fat content. You can use any concentration of isopropyl alcohol. As you clean, be sure to get in corners and around the red O-ring. Be careful not to bend the fan blades when wiping down the surface area of the sample chamber. Change chem wipes frequently, even if they appear clean. If the chem wipe appears dirty after cleaning, get a new chem wipe and repeat the cleaning process. Be careful not to dip a used chem wipe into the cleaning solution, alcohol, or distilled water to avoid cross-contamination. Now, rinse the surface area just washed. Get a new large chem wipe and moisten it with clean distilled water. Repeat the same process. Remember not to dip a dirty chem wipe into your clean distilled water. Dry the sample chamber with a new, dry chem wipe. Once the surface area of the sample chamber is clean, clean in and around the fan and the sensors. To do this, use a cleaning rod, strips of chem wipes, and isopropyl alcohol or AQUALAB cleaning solution. Wrap a chem wipe strip on the top of the cleaning stick. The first step to wrapping a chem wipe is to make 2 folds. One fold over the head of the stick, and one over the top to cover the tip of the head. Then twist the stick with one hand while holding onto the chem wipe with your other hand until the head of the stick is covered. It's important not to use a commercial swab because the adhesives used to glue the cotton to the stick will contaminate the mirror and sensors. Chem wipes won't scratch the mirror and are adhesive-free and low lint. Repeating the same clean, rinse, dry process used to clean the sample chamber, wash, rinse, and dry. Now that the block surfaces are clean, it's time to clean the sensors. There are 3 sensors to be cleaned: the thermopile, the mirror, and the optical sensor. If you have the AQUALAB 4TEV, vapor sorption analyzer, pocket, or light, do not allow any moisture to come into contact with the filter, shown here. Again, first with a clean chem wipe and isopropyl alcohol or AQUALAB cleaning solution, then with a fresh chem wipe and distilled water, and finally with a clean, dry chem wipe. To review, wash, rinse, and dry the sample chamber surface area, wash, rinse, and dry around the fan, washing with isopropyl alcohol or AQUALAB cleaning solution helps break down contaminants. The rinsing step washes away the contaminants, and the drying step leaves the surface clean and dry. Once the cleaning process is complete, let the sample chamber dry for about 5 minutes while you prepare your water activity standards for verification. We're going to designate the lot number for this sample in Scala, but you can do this manually also. Remove the lid if necessary and put the sample in the AQUALAB. Close the top and slide the lever to read. Scala will listen for and record the reading, but you can also check the reading on the AQUALAB screen. In 1 or 2 minutes, a preliminary number will show. The spinning wheel at the bottom of the screen indicates the AQUALAB is still checking to see if the sample has stabilized. If you are recording readings manually, you can listen for the beep that shows that the instrument is done. Your final water activity reading will show on the screen.